Okay, we're off target. That run looked fine from up here. How are the cameras?
Roger. Camera's functioning. Let's get a sky shot and go on home.
Pulling out left. Give me a 77 on the INS.
Okay, sir. This is our first checkpoint. This is the area here. Yes, sir. That looks like it right there. Yes, that's it.
Assignment, aerial reconnaissance. Reconnaissance that includes photography, radar, or infrared and ultraviolet sensing devices. A wide range of modern techniques.
Charlie, and Skipper, you'll be Pigment 75, mission number Charlie Yankee 4001.
There'll be no fighter escort required. Mission, primary mission, will be strip and pinpoint photos of suspected heavy enemy truck movements along Route 9 into the caisson area.
Time on target, 1300. Communications-wise, no changes. Squadron primary remains 2828. IFF, mode 1, squad 03, and mode 3, 23 and 25, coming back. Weather, local existing at the 9, 2500 scattered, 10,000 broken, with 6 plus visibility. And forecast no change for your ETA. Vert field, U-Bahn and U-Dorm are clear, some high scattered, two lie about the same as the name. All field facilities are up, and the approach and midfield arresting gear status is up.
The enemy situation, there is a small arms fire along Route 9, where you'll be flying your photo, and suspected 37 and 57, radar-directed AAA in the Line Bay Pass.
Two briefings precede each mission. First, the overall assignment, target, enemy defenses, fighter support, and other critical considerations.
Bob, that's Sparky Dask in the north.
What's the terrain like?
The elevation along the road to the pass where you'll be shooting is 1,000 feet. There are hills on either side of the road, 22 to 2,300 feet.
Morning, sirs. Got a priority one target for you this morning. I'd like to have you make one run along Highway 9. Just south of caisson, using all three of your camera stations. The altitude be 1,000 feet AGL, 1,200 feet MSL. All your camera stations, sir, are loaded with full rolls of film. Your station one will have a KS-87 6-inch focal length lens. Your station two will have a K-56 low altitude pan with a 3-inch focal length lens. And your station three, sir, will have a split vert configuration with KS-87 6-inch focal length.
The second briefing lays out the photographic aspects of the mission. The pilot and observer concern themselves with camera stations, the primary camera, the backup camera, the technical factors.
Yes, Sarge, do you want the cameras on all the way down this road, or you just want the two targets?
Right, so you'd like to have your cameras on the start of the run here at this point, run them all the way through to this point, then bank off. The circled points, sir, are points of most interest at this time.
Okay, do you want my station one in vertical or blight?
I'd like to have it in vertical, sir.
Okay, Andy, you've got the
radios. Teamwork of these two men is of critical importance, not only to the aerial mission, but to ground operations to follow. When combating an elusive enemy who frequently moves by night and works in small numbers, in mountainous terrain with heavy cover, often moving supplies by bicycle, it can be extremely difficult to locate his position. One photo mission by these two men can make the difference.
Have a good hop, sir.
Thank you. Say, Andy, which aircraft do we have?
Number 15, I think.
15, I flew that yesterday. That's a good aircraft.
Just back from Farsman.
Yeah, it sure is.
Okay, Bob, I'm just going to stop by the parallel for a minute, pick up my mask.
All right, Andy, I'll meet you in the flight line with your gear on.
Good enough.
Behind each flight mission is a complex of sophisticated electronic equipment, which must be continually checked and maintained. For modern surveillance aircraft to do their job requires knowledge in the heads of the men on the ground and skill in their hands. A complete film processing unit is ready to develop and print photographs, making the information recorded available to intelligence personnel in the shortest possible time. Enemy air defenses are not ignored. Photo missions, frequently requiring low altitudes at high speeds, means special attention to ejection seat equipment. Maintenance work seems unending. Aircraft requires hours of servicing for every hour of flight. Each photo mission is individual. Cameras for that mission, lenses specially selected, angles precisely calculated, are carefully installed. Complex aiming, exposure, and triggering mechanisms for each camera are connected to dual controls so that they can be operated by either the pilot or the observer. Continual inspections are made for previously undetected damage from enemy fire or any other defects which could cause the mission to fail. Ejection seats are double-checked for obvious reasons. In fact, just before takeoff, the entire aircraft is given a final inspection by its skilled maintenance crew. Finally, specially chosen magazines of film are delivered for loading into the carefully mounted cameras. The final inspection is by the pilot himself. Before each mission, he makes a personal check, a complete visual examination of his aircraft. He knows the places to check for possible trouble.
Runway 17 right, altimeter 29 or 88.
Roger, 29 or 88.
Denang Tower, Pigment 51, takeoff with Fox 4.
Pigment 51, position and hold. Runway 17 right.
Roger, position and hold on the right.
Pigment 51, cleared for takeoff. Runway 17 right, wind 190 at 8 knots.
Roger, clear off the right. Pigment 51's on a roll.
The culmination of so much work by so many Marine specialists is at hand. The test, the mission, sweeping low over enemy-dominated terrain.
Cameras on. Roger. Cameras on. 77 in the INS. Let's make it home.
Now it is a matter of time. If there was something on that road recorded by the cameras, the location can be identified and action taken. We suspect that the enemy has been in this area. Now is the time to pin him down. This then is aerial reconnaissance, combining the eyes of the eagle, the intelligence of men, and modern firepower. Almost before the aircraft rolls to a stop, the cameras will be unloaded and the magazines rushed on their way to the film processing unit. Pilots normally go to the film processing center to check the results of the flight and to determine that all camera equipment was functioning correctly. The proof is in the film.
Okay, off to the right-hand side here, you can see the trucks leading off the road where the truck park is. Of course, there's quite a few along the road here.
I can see those with my naked eye. Let's see what I have here.
Okay, sir, I think I found the truck park right here in this area.
Right, it's up on the right side of the road there.
Yeah.
How about the trucks down there in the bottom of the negative?
Yes, sir, they're all full. Moving right down the road.
They are moving?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
The pilot knows that much depends on the clarity of the images that he brought back. If they are not good or show no results, the danger will have been risked without gain. Good pictures and good intelligence can bring sudden action by artillery, ground or air, with a devastating effect on the enemy.
Okay, I think
one picture can save 1,000 lives and win a battle.
That should be the end of the target.
Yes, sir. I think we've got 100% target completion here. Good job, sir.
That's great, Sergeant. Will this get out in time tonight for the attack sorties?
The aerial reconnaissance mission of Marine Corps Aviation is one more of the tough, dangerous, highly sophisticated specialties that go into making the Marines a complete fighting team. Mission, find the enemy from the air. Mission accomplished. Enemy sighted, plotted, and destroyed.